Bonjour, bienvenue sur ma chaîne YouTube. We're gonna have a new lesson, but first let me remind you about the remote learning. You need 1. To work in your book or a piece of paper on Google Document. 2. Write your day, title and objectives. 3. Watch the YouTube video. 4. Pause when you need to complete an exercise. 5. Self-mark all your work with another color pen. 6. Each exercise must be clearly labeled. 7. Once you are finished, you need to attach your work to your assignment on Google Classroom and click on Submit. And finally, you need to complete your SEQ or your quiz after each timetable lesson. Here are the key instructions in French that I will repeat. Écoutez means listen. Je répète, I repeat. Voilà la réponse, here is the answer. Vérifiez vos réponses, check your answers. And now let's start the lesson. So, newsflash, I couldn't find any music background for it. You can just imagine it. We are starting a new module about town. So today we're going to learn about the weather because it's important that you say, I live in York, today the weather is nice, or it's raining or it's snowing. But next we will learn about compass point to say York is in the northeast of England. We will also learn about places in town, les endroits en ville, like shops, different type of shops, and the activities that you can do in town, and the direction, you know, the shop is on the right, or go straight ahead and turn right. But now we're going to focus on the weather. So please write down your title and your objective and do your bell task. So the title today is Quel temps fait-il? Quel temps fait-il? What is the weather like? And your objective is to learn weather expression in French. Because the mood can be influenced by the weather, I thought as a bell task, it would be nice for you to remember how to say, I'm fine, but I'm tired, I'm fine, and I'm happy. So you have a challenge. How do you say in French, I am not happy? If you look at the sentence builder, you have, I am happy. So let's see if you remember how to make it a negative sentence. And you have also a super challenge. I just gave you an extra piece of information, which is donc, meaning therefore. So it would be nice if you could use it in a statement. For example, I am happy, therefore, I'm well, or I am tired, therefore I am very bad. Pause. Voilà les réponses. So if you wanted to say I am not happy, is je ne suis pas content. You need to add the ne and the pas. Now we're going to do a listening exercise. So in your book, write down listening exercise. You have here a sentence builder about the weather. You have several expressions. We're gonna learn how to say it's nice weather, bad weather, hot, cold, give the temperature, when it's positive or minus. We're gonna learn how to say it's sunny, windy, cloudy, foggy, stormy, it's raining, it's snowing, it's freezing, okay? So quite a lot of vocabulary. So first of all, I would like you to repeat after me. So I won't be able to hear you, but I just hope you're doing it at home. So, let's look at column A. Repeat after me. Répétez après moi. Il fait. Number 2. Il y a. Number 3. Il pleut. Number 4. Il neige. Number 5. Il gèle. And let's look at column B now. We have beau. Répétez après moi, repeat after me. Beau. Then mauvais. Then chaud. Then number 4, froid. Number 5, 20 degrés. Number 6, moins 5 degrés. And then in the blue part of this column B, we have number one, du soleil. Number two, du vent. Number three, des nuages. Number four, du brouillard. Number five, de l'orage. So what I would like you to do is to look on the right-hand side. It's written, write down how these words sound like. So hopefully you repeated them. But now, can you please just write these words in either write the full sentence builder or do a screenshot and then you can annotate each word with how they sound like, or write down this list of words that I put on the right-hand side and then you will be able to write down how they sound like. Okay? So pause it while you write your list of words or write down your sentence builder. Okay, now, so I'm going to say each of these words. Please write down how they sound, and I'm going to show you the answer almost straight away, okay? So you can check it. Numéro 1, so beau. It is how it sounds. Please write it down next to beau. Mauvais. How would you write it? How does it sound like? It sounds like this, mauvais. Then we have chaud. Froid. Froid. Fait. Moins. Moins. So when I put the one, is one in French, okay? Me, we, un, moins. Then, soleil, vent, so we don't pronounce the T, nuage, brouillard, pleu. Now, please, this work, you do not have to write anything in your book. I'm going to say something in French and I'm going to count for about five seconds, and you need to try to say out loud what it means. So I'll give you an example. If I say, il fait beau, what does it mean in English? So I count to five. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq. Hopefully it gives you enough time to read through the sentence builder and to have said out loud, oh yeah, it means it is nice weather. Number two. It's number two now, but it's an example. So what does it mean if I say, il fait chaud? Il fait chaud. It means it is hot weather. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? I mean, what does it mean? Il fait froid. Il fait froid. It means it's cold weather. Il fait mauvais. Il fait mauvais. It means it is bad weather. Il fait 20 degrés. Il fait 20 degrés. It is 20 degrees. Well done. And the last one. Il fait moins 5 degrés. Il fait moins 5 degrés. Well done, it means it is minus 5 degrees. Looking at the blue column now, the blue line, sorry. What does it mean if I say il y a du vent? Il y a du vent. Yes, it means it's windy. Il y a de l'orage. Il y a de l'orage. Yes, it means stormy. Il y a du soleil. Il y a du soleil. It means it's sunny. Il y a du brouillard. Il y a du brouillard. It means it's foggy. Il y a des nuages. Il y a des nuages. It means it is cloudy. Well done. So now we're going to move on to the next exercise. I just would like you, because I'm sure you all notice that sometimes it starts with il fait, sometimes it starts with il y a, but do you know, when do we use il fait and when do you use il y a? So I would like you to use your observation power and to try to write a rule about it. When do we start the sentence with il fait, when you want to give the weather, or when do you start it with il y a? So I'll give you a little bit of a head start. Il fait is followed by, so what is it followed by? Il y a is followed by, what is it followed by? Look at the column B. Pause it, have a go at it. Voilà la réponse, here is the answer. So I hope you notice, il fait is followed by adjective describing word, nice, bad, hot, cold, or a temperature. Okay, so it's an adjective or a number, like a temperature. However, il y a is followed by, because il y a actually means there is or there are. So word for word, it would mean there is some sun, there is some wind, there is some cloud. So il y a is actually followed by a noun, a thing, okay? So I hope you notice that because it will really help you not to make any mistake when you talk about the weather. Now, little memory check. You only need to, so write in your book, memory check. You only need to match the numbers and letters. Let's see if you remember what they mean, okay? So you just need to write the number. For example, number one, il fait froid, would go with E. Yes, the letter E, it is cold. Please pause it. Voilà les réponses. Here are the answers. So self-mark it. And a little bit of extra work. Can you please practice your pronunciation? And remember, all the underlined letters are silent. Pause it. Just remind you, il fait froid, il y a du soleil, il fait chaud, il y a du brouillard, il y a du vent. Now, I would like you to use your sentence builder if you need it, because you just seen this expression. But I would like you to translate from French to English these sentences. And you have a little challenge, complete sentence 6 with therefore I'm tired. Okay, so pause it. Voilà les réponses. Here are the answers. So I'll let you mark it. You can pause again. Next exercise is a translation, but this time a little bit harder, from English to French. So pause it again. Use your sentence builder if needed. Et voilà la réponse. Here are the answers. So pause it if you want to self-mark it. Now it's just a little, it's just, you don't need to write anything down for this exercise. I'm just going to say one weather in French and you just have to think about which number it is. So we have number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? So if I say il pleut, which number is it? It was numéro 3, number 3. Si je dis, if I say il y a du soleil, it was numéro 5. Which number is it if I say il neige, it was numéro 1, number 1. And which number is it if I say il y a des nuages, il y a des nuages, it was numéro 6. Okay, I didn't say all of them. But just for us to refresh our memory, can you please repeat after me? Numéro 1, number 1, il neige. Numéro 2, il y a de l'orage. Numéro 3, il pleut. Numéro 4, il gèle. Numéro 5, il y a du soleil. Numéro 6, il y a des nuages. So again, you don't need to write anything, but one picture is going to disappear and you can try, still looking at your sentence builder, it's fine, but try to find out which, how do you say the French sentence? So this one disappeared. Which one was it? Then this one. It was it snowing. And this one. The one about the storm. This one? It's freezing. That one? This one could be it's sunny or it's hot or it's nice weather. And the last one, which is left. How would you say that in French? That was using a lot of your memory skill, okay? So it's not something you can learn very quickly. You really need to take the time to practice. A little extra, so for most of you, if you want to stop here, you can. But extra, if you want to practice, I put Monday weather forecast, la météo du lundi. And I would like you to write down the weather for the circle part. So I'm going to give you an example on the right-hand side. So it's sunny everywhere and it's more than 30 degrees, okay? The challenge is to add the average temperature. Il fait environ, it means it is about, okay? So that would be what I expect. You could either write down il fait beau, it's nice weather, il fait chaud, it's hot weather, il y a du soleil, it's sunny, il fait environ 30 degrés, that's the challenge, it is about 30 degrees. So please pause it in order to try to do the left-hand side part. Voilà la réponse. So here is la météo du mardi, Tuesday's weather forecast. Oh, by the way, this is France, of course. I'm sure that you all know it. So I'll let you do it, pause it. Voilà la réponse. And I gave you the Wednesday as well, weather forecast. Pause it. Voilà la réponse. I don't know if you noticed, but I had added the challenge. Beaucoup de mean a lot of. So if you want to say there are a lot of cloud, it is il y a beaucoup de. And how do we say cloud? It's nuage. Il y a beaucoup de nuages. Well, and now it's your moment of reflection. This is the end of the lesson for today. I would like you to jot down, what did you find easy? What did you find the most difficult? What areas for improvement can you identify? And what is your way forward? Be specific. We can do it, c'est possible, tu peux le faire. I hope you enjoy this this lesson about weather. There will be some Quizlet flashcards coming up for the next lesson. And au revoir.